Welcome back to the Jordan Challenge. It is the Portland Trail Blazers vs. the Bulls, June 3rd, 1992, the NBA Finals, game number one, the Shrug. Let's go. So we need to win the game. Hit 6 threes in the first half and then score 39 points and hold Clyde to drive Dressler to under 17 points.
When Michael Jordan played in Chicago, the crowd just went crazy to another decibel level. And I'd get the chills every time. He played with such a fury. He was electric on the court. Before the Shrug game, the game against Portland in the NBA Finals, well, the public relations people couldn't find Michael. The reason was he was on the court taking three-point shots, and he was not noted as a three-point shooter. We asked him about it. He said, well, you know, you never know when a three-point shot might come in handy. Obviously, he had figured something out, that he was going to surprise them, but you have to hit the shots. This incredible onslaught of threes takes place in the first half, and he hits six of them. That was unheard of at that time for anyone. He looks over at our broadcast table and gives that shrug. And I think what I took out of that most, it showed his humility that he could not believe that he hit 6 3-pointers. That was, I thought, one of the incredible moments in playoff history. I would have to go with Jordan as the GOAT.
Playing in the NBA Finals, motivation is a given. But if bulletin board material carries weight, the Blazers have plenty. The defending champion Bulls have added their voices to a chorus casting Portland as a paper tiger with talent to burn, but unable to stick to a winning script. Now, can the Blazers shred that narrative and write their own championship chapter?
The banks of Lake Michigan.
And now, the starting lineup for your world champion, Chicago Bulls! A 6-2 guard from Notre Dame, the man in the middle out of San Francisco, 7-1, Bill Cartwright. And forward from Clemson, 6'10", forward, 6'8", from Central Arkansas, Scotty Pippen. From North Carolina, head guard, 6'6", Michael Jordan. The head coach of your Bulls is Phil Jackson.
The stage is set here in Chicago. Welcome everyone to game one of the NBA Finals. The Portland Trail Blazers and the defending champion Chicago Bulls. Along with coach Mike Fratello, former player Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, I'm Kevin Harlan. And Mike, a Blazers team that some have questioned, what is their mentality?
Well, they've made it clear. They're out to prove a point that they're ready for this moment and that they can deliver in the clutch.
And the two leading stars for these teams. Clark, it's Clyde Drexler and Michael Jordan. Their games invite comparison, I think.
They sure do, Kevin. A lot of similarities when you look at them, from their age to the versatility and athleticism of their games. Air Jordan and Clyde the Glide, both cleared for takeoff.
On the floor for Portland, it'll be Terry Porter and Clyde Drexler in the backcourt. Up front, Jerome Kersey is at small forward, Buck Williams at the four. Handling the low post is Kevin Duckworth. For the Bulls, Bill Cartwright is at the center. Scottie Pippen and Horace Grant man the front court. John Paxson is at the point. And of course, at off guard, it'll be Michael Jordan.
And the Blazers certainly motivated to answer their detractors. That's a question they know can't be answered with words, but rather with their performance on the floor.
Now, here's Porter. And here's Kersey. Back to Porter. Just five to shoot. Ring shot on the way. It's hauled in by the Bulls. And Clark, the Blazers like to play a much faster pace than the Bulls.
Certainly, Kevin. They will be looking to push the tempo. You can count on that. And that could help them with their execution, in my mind. Much simpler pushing the ball with a numbers advantage than going against the set half-court defense.
Ah, great scouting report. So the Chicago Bulls able to put up the first points on the board. And the officials calling for a three-second violation. Bulls ball. Here's Chicago. It's a three-point game. Mike, one thing with this matchup, Terry Porter has really struggled against the Bulls in the past.
Definitely not a good sign for the Blazers. Porter's one of their most important players. They need him to come up big in this series. And in my mind, the most fascinating individual matchup in this series is Drexler going up against Michael Jordan. Jordan's going to have his work cut out on the defensive end.
Yeah, I could not agree with you more, Coach. Yeah, you know, MJ's guarding the guy who's averaging 27 points a game in the playoffs in Drexler. So he's going to have to really do a lot of work at both ends of the floor.
No good from Paxson. For the Trailblazers, it's been a slow start here. Porter inside. Guarded by Paxson. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
There's a toughness Porter brings to this team. Physically and mentally.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
Terry Porter at the line for two.
And he knocks down the first one.
And in the run-up to this series, Phil Jackson really tried to establish a mental edge. His comments about the Blazers were pretty scathing.
I don't think there's a coach that's been any better at jabbing the other team. We know how Phil Jackson operates. The Blazers, though, are a tested and veteran team. Phil's remarks possibly could backfire, being just what the Blazers need to get out to a fast start.
Jordan passes to Paxson. Good, and it's Jordan picking up the assist.
Such a savvy distributor. Jordan's court awareness and understanding for when his guys are open is impressive.
Pass to Williams, and here's Drexler. Now Duckworth. Bill Cartwright grabs the rebound. And one thing the Bulls have been relying on is Jordan's scoring, Clark, in the post.
That's been a bit of a surprise tactic for them in the playoffs, and it's paid dividends. More and more, they're setting up Jordan on the block. We'll see if they stick with that tonight.
And plenty of storylines coming into this series. Let's check in with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge, for more on that. David.
Okay, guys, one of the stories coming into the finals is the health of Michael Jordan. He had a sore wrist in Game 6 of the Eastern Conference Finals, and it caused him to miss 15 of his first 20 shots. But Jordan insists the wrist is just fine. He went through his game day weightlifting routine this morning with no restrictions. Back to you.
That is a good sign. David, thank you very much. Mike, lifting weights like that today, that looks like a thumbs up. What do you think?
Yeah, that's not something you do on a game day with a bad wrist. And Jordan's such a competitor that even if he is banged up, he'll fight right through it.
Always has, you're right. And Mike, after his poor shooting night last time out, everyone wondering how Michael Jordan will respond tonight.
Well, Kev, we'll see very shortly. Sometimes that only helps to fire him up. Opponents are scared of Jordan coming off a bad game. He goes out there trying to prove himself all over again.
And usually is successful. Now, here's Jordan. He has five. Jordan nails the triple, his seventh. Tremendous action so far between the Bulls and the Trailblazers.
And with Jordan leading the way, the Bulls won their first title last year. I'm not sure they'll have to wait long for another one.
Williams passes to Armstrong. Jordan with it. Drexler defending. Launches it. Tying an NBA Finals record in a half. Michael Jordan with his third three, providing an early lift for the Chicago Bulls. Livingston is out there with Williams. Then it's B.J. Armstrong. And it's Michael Jordan. And it's Pippen in at the small forward. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. And the pass to Porter. Wide open. And the Trailblazers getting another bucket right there. And when we talk about Jordan, we're talking about a man, Clark, in the prime of his career. And the four-three-pointer falls for Jordan. The NBA Finals record is six. He's knocking on the door and getting oh so close. Mike, I'd say any questions about Jordan's bad wrist have now been answered.
It's not affecting him at all, and he's taking advantage of some really soft Portland D. By the look of it, MJ's going to make this a long night for the Blazers.
Here's Jordan. And Pippen with the basket. The assist from Michael Jordan. Jordan's got three assists tonight. Outside, Drexler. We're closing in on 2 minutes played here in the second quarter. Porter kicks to Drexler. Pass to Williams. Here is Bryant. He's guarded by Williams. And a nice shot by Bryant.
The Bulls continue to share the ball. They're unselfish, active, and finding points easily at the moment.
And right away, we can see the one-on-one battle, Mike, between Jordan and Drexler. That triple gives Jordan five. Michael Jordan is just 1 3-pointer away from an NBA Finals record.
And the Bulls might be a little short on the bench. Craig Hodges has been limited with a bad ankle.
Outside Williams, pass to Kersey. Now here's Drexler. And stolen by Williams. And here we go, fast break, Jordan's got it. Let's it go with a three. Tying the NBA Finals record. Michael Jordan with an exceptional display of shooting. That was his sixth three-pointer in this game. Outside Drexler. Now, here's Porter. He has six. Here's Williams. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Williams has got his first bucket of the night. And Clark, is for Hodges, he might not play a lot of minutes now with that injury, but he certainly, when he does, he's a catalyst for them.
Yeah, Kevin, he's really an instant offense guy. I mean, can come in and knock down big three-pointers if the offense needs it, but unfortunately, the Bulls might not have that usual spark of his off the bench.
Time call here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. We've seen Michael Jordan. It's happened for the Chicago Bulls. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12. 29-32. Welcome into the third quarter here in Chicago, folks. The Bulls in pursuit of their second consecutive NBA title. A win here in game one would go a long way toward making that happen.
And I don't know how Michael Jordan can follow up that performance in the first half. But we'll find out.
They recover it. Paxson kicks to Grant. Goes back up. Pippen, no luck.
You know, you look at Pippen's performance, and it's pretty obvious to me he's not going full speed, and I just hope he's feeling okay out there.
On the floor for Portland. Kevin Duckworth is out there with Robinson. Then there's Kersey, then there's Porter, and it's Drexler in at the two-guard position.
And you know what, Kevin? Portland's got to be terrified. I mean, we thought his wrist might affect him. Instead, Jordan looks now like he's never been better.
He's incredible. Robinson dishes to Porter. And that's good. Robinson picking up the assist. Robinson's got four assists now tonight. And Jordan, Mike, is just tormenting the Blazers from three-point range.
It's going to take a much sharper effort from Portland defensively. They can't give Jordan an inch of room on the perimeter anymore.
Porter finds Drexler. And the Trailblazers, another three.
Wasting no time on the catch. I love seeing Drexler go into attack mode right away.
And here's Jordan outside. The offensive rebound. Grant the pass to Cartwright. Another shot, and the Bulls tack on two more.
He's been a reliable offensive option, currently maintaining an impressive field goal percentage in this game.
Drexler outside. Good ball movement here by the Trailblazers. And it's slammed in by Duckworth.
Easy assist there from Porter. He certainly finds the open man with ease.
Kicks it out to Grant. Right side, Jordan. Over Drexler. Paxson against Porter. Jordan outside. The three. The roof here in Chicago's gonna blow off. Michael Jordan just collected his seventh shot from beyond the three-point line. That's an NBA Finals record.
And the Bulls have talked a lot about the Blazers being soft late in games. It'll be interesting to see how they respond if a game gets tight.
And Pippen gets it to go.
And Pippen has never been one to back down from the aggressive coverage, welcoming the contact on the...
We're just over a minute and a half now into the fourth. Pippen against Robinson. Good work there as it goes.
And for all the talk of the Blazers' tendency to self-destruct late in games, this is a team with plenty of playoff experience.
Jordan against Ainge. And Jordan gets it to go. Jordan's got 47 points.
And Jordan is simply amazing at finishing through contact. Doesn't matter what you throw at him or who, he finds a way to score. These offenses have been so sharp, so focused, so dialed in, and neither one is slowing down in the late game.
Jordan is now closing in on the most points in an NBA Finals half. Can he get to 33?
No room for error there because he threw it down with both hands.
Pretty smart. Yeah, with the score this close, you can't afford any mistakes.
Boy, a miss slam would have been deflating. Nice to see him finish it off.
Ainge with the ball. Got a piece of it. Pippen with the steal. And here's the fast break. Jordan leading the way. Cartwright, the pass to Pippen. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Out left to the wing.
2 minutes remaining.
Lock at six.
Game. 2 minutes.
Jordan down low. Robinson on him. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It's going to be on Buck Williams. And you talk about the Blazers' playoff experience, though. It's up and down the bench.
You're right, Kevin. It's not just the four guys. I mean, they've got players like Ainge, Hooper, Buck Williams. I mean, these guys are veterans with years of postseason games under their belt.
Second one is good. Getting both at the line. And it's worth. Here's Drexler. And Drexler throws it down.
Drexler, dependable at knocking down big shots. And that's why he's so well respected.
Jordan looking around. From deep. Portland grabs the miss. Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. On the wing, Drexler to tie it up. And again, it's the Trailblazers from deep.
This is encouraging to see from Drexler, wanting to space the floor more with his outside shooting and doing so there.
Jordan kicks to Pippen. Good, and it's Jordan picking up the assist. Jordan's got his seventh assist in the...
Blazers substitute.
execution.
Here's Trexler. .105 left to play here in the fourth. And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession. He'll have a jump ball. And Chicago has possession. And so Grant will bring it up for the Bulls. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. A deep three from Jordan. Here's Cartwright. It drops.
Now that is how you come through when it matters most.
He has ice in his veins. Biggest shot of the game, and he converts it.
Pass to Kersey. And a wide open look for Porter. Got it! And that shot brings them to within just one.
Staying under control, Porter delivers in the clutch. And this guy does not fear the big moment.
Jordan against Drexler. Michael Jordan on the wing. Just five on the clock. Grant in the post. He's guarded by Williams.
Good! When you gotta have a hoop, Grant is a very good option because he can just play bully ball and get into his shot.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. They're trailing by three. There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What do you think, guys?
This is a tricky situation. I mean, they need to get some kind of bucket to stay alive. They got to do it fast, though.
Either a three-pointer or score quickly and take the foul. In a clutch situation, Drexler embraces the challenge and works twice as hard to find the bucket.
Chicago calls timeout. They're leading by one. 8 seconds left in the fourth quarter. 8 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. And an intentional foul right there.
Yeah, that's a good play. I mean, fouling there in hopes of staying alive in this one, that's the right play.
They need every second they can get at this point. Do whatever they can to come back.
That's the first, and that will put them up by two.
In crunch time, everyone knows the ball is going to Michael Jordan.
And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a three-point game.
And what a huge trip to the line that was. Gets them all and makes it a three-point lead.
Oh, he couldn't make that shot go to force overtime. And with his victory, the Bulls stand just three wins away, Mike Fratello, from their second pin.
The Trailblazers, 73. Thank you, everyone, for making it out. It's a...
If you guys have enjoyed this video, hit the like, hit the subscribe button. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.